members. Well, dear learners, I once again thank you all for joining this online class on accounting standard and trial balance. And I request Dr. Jenna to begin the session with a thumping note. And I also request him to take over the class from me. And here, I also request the learner, rather I take this opportunity to request the learners to ensure submission of their assignments. You must have known the last date. Till date, the last date has been decided at 14 June. Again, another sincere request to all of you is that since here, online classes, we are unable to use blackboards and Sir is showing mostly the through PPTs, PowerPoint presentation, please go through the SLMs at home before the class as well as after the class. Thank you. Wish you a good afternoon and a lively lecture. Thank you very much. Sir, you can start right now.
Thank you, sir. Good afternoon to the learners. We will be starting the PPT. And today is a very important block. We will be covering 5 units and all very, very important. 2 of them are a little bit difficult, but I will make it very easy for you to understand. First one is of accounting standard. Second one is of trial balance, third is depreciation, fourth is rectification error, and fifth is bank questions. I think the PPT is visible.
Yes, sir.
This is VBA 4, Block 3. The content name is reporting standard and trial balance. First of all, I would want to make very clear to the learners. So, what is the significance of accounting standard and why it came to account? We have the learners may ask questions. Sir, we have Companies Act. We have different acts, suppose payment of bonus act, payment of wages act, also which are related to accounts. When you're paying income tax, also we have income tax act. But still, apart from the act, there are some standards which also gives us some code of conduct to be imposed by the accountant. So that might be something which might have been missed in that act, which have been implemented or incorporated in the accounting standard. So due to some limitation of the act or something has been not reflected in the act, that's why the concept of accounting standard came into account. There are also some limitation of accounting standard also. Some guidance notes also comes in account and also amendment also makes amendment, regular amendment every year. So this is the provision. There is some limitation. That's why another concept came into account. So here, who makes accounting standard? The central government has framed a body known as Accounting Standard Board. It has a committee known as National Advisory Body on Accounting Standard. It has given the role to the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India to give some suggestion, to implement it, to make revision in the standard, to provide proper accounting treatment. So accounting standards are made by the Accounting Standard Board in consultation with the committee known as National Advisory Body on Accounting Standard, and they're overviewed by the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. All the chartered accountants, they give their suggestion because they're experts in accounts. And these accounting standards are the rules, regulations relating to maintaining accounts in a proper manner so that the accounts does not have any future illegality. Because whatever you do, you have to have a check on it. You have to keep a record on it. You have to verify it. And you have to produce it. We have already known that accounting is the language of business. Because you have to show to accounts should be shown to the public, accounts should be shown to the government, accounts should be shown to the income tax authority, accounts should be shown to the researcher, accounts should be shown to the government. So, what are the rules and regulations have been followed by the accountant? That is a very important criteria. In the words of Kohler, an accounting standard is defined as a code of conduct. So, we should give a code of conduct to everything. to whom the code of conduct should be given? To an accountant. By custom, by law, or by professional body. By professional body, by Institute of Chartered Accountants in India. By law, we know that we have the High Court and Supreme Court, etc. And by custom, which is inherent, that we have to, for every debit, there must be a credit. This is the custom. You cannot have, when you are following double entry system of bookkeeping, and we are maintaining accounts, you have to keep record of that for every debit, there must be a credit. This is an important criteria because this is a golden rule of accounting. Then we'll go to what is the accounting standard. It is the accounting principles and rules. We have already studied the accounting principles and rules, which are to be followed over various accounting treatment. So while maintaining accounts, keeping records of the accounts, while putting an entry, you have to give the treatment, which I already discussed in the final account in the previous classes. What treatment? Which side it will go? Either it's a debit account or a credit account. This is the treatment. And where it will be posted? Either it will be posted in trading account, it will be posted in profit loss account, it posted in balanced. While preparing financial statement. Financial statement means trading profit loss account and balance sheet. On uniform basis. What about the policy and treatment should be on uniform basis? There should not be any on differential basis. Because if you put any policy, any treatment on differential basis, then one side of the account will not tell you. And will reveal the same meaning to all the interested group who will use the same. I have told the interested group may be government, maybe research organization, maybe public, maybe tax authority, maybe central government, maybe corporate organization, maybe financial institution, banks, etc., insurance organization, etc. Everybody needs accounts, and the accounts should follow some rules and regulations. The rules and regulations which are followed by the accounts as per Company Act 1956, which has been now Company Act 2013. Apart from that, there are some standards which tells something more apart from that to be followed and while maintaining accounts. Because it acts as a guide, it guides us how to go through the process from beginning to the end. And it acts as a dictator. Dictator means whatever the rules and whatever the standard tells us, we have to follow that. We cannot deviate from the standard. Service provided, it provides us service because it tells us what to do, what not to do. Harmonizer. It is act as a good, the accounting standard maintains good relationship between the organization and the outside world. If you have applied the accounting standard, the public and the investor will be very happy and will be more reluctant to invest on your company. We'll go to second PPT. Benefits of accounting standard. Why we use accounting standard? Because you can identify the problem. When you identify the problem, then you apply the standard. The problem will be solved. Standardized accounts. The account standardized account means application of rules and regulations. Account is standardized means rules and regulations have been applied in the account and it obey all the legalities as per each and every act. Companies Act 1956 or 2013, Insurance Act, every electricity act, if you are maintaining accounts of electricity, whichever accounts are maintaining, if you are putting the standard means we are complying with all the rules and regulations. Private regulation. Private regulation also has to comply with the accounting standard. They cannot deviate from the accounting standard if they are maintaining accounts. International accounting standard. Yes, nowadays the Indian accounting standard is now going to be already has been replaced by IFRS. We'll be studying in the later part of the PPT in International Financial Reporting Standard. Why it has been replaced? I'm telling it because when a person from India is going to Australia, the accounts of Australia is different and accounts of India is different. And the person from Australia is coming to India, that person is unable to understand the accounting system of India. In order to maintain a standard in whole world, so the accounting standard are told to be maintained similar throughout the world. That is known as International Financial Reporting Standard. So wherever you go, or the accounts and the audit people can identify the standard. You go to America, your America people can come to India, they can identify, they can understand the standard and implement the accounts and audit work. So it increases the scope of accountancy profession, audit profession. It is transparent for user and comparable all period presented. And you know, the standards are very transparent because accounting information are displayed and presented in paper, published in paper. You know, accounting is the language of business, you have to publish it. Which period you have all the information either in the website, annual report, or either it published in the paper, you can compare. Out of the accounting standard adopted by last year in case of depreciation, and this year what accounting standard it has been applied. What method has been applied last year depreciation, and this year why last year written down method is applied, and this year it is applied straight line. Why there is a change? You can easily identify. Provide a suitable starting point for accounting and accountants in India. Because it is the basis. Because it is the rule, it is the law, it is the guidance. It is the basis on which you have to prepare the account. You have to know the rules and regulations. Without knowing this, you have to unable to prepare the accounts and will face a lot of difficulties in times of audit. Can be generated a cost that does not exceed benefit. So the accounting standard should be implied by those persons who study accountants. And the cost should not exceed does not exceed benefit. We always want that the benefit should be more than cost. So while applying this accounting standard, we'll get more benefit, the cost will be less. Procedure for issuing accounting standard in India. How accounting standard in India was issued? I have already told accounting standard has been taken care of by accounting standard board in consultation with a committee or body known as National Advisory Committee on Accounting Standard. And the ICAI to finalize. First, we have to determine why there is a need of accounting standard. Because there may be some thing which has been left in the Companies Act 2013. Constituting study group. Who constitute the study group? All the chartered accountant or members of Institute of Chartered Accountant India who are qualified chartered accountant, they constitute the group. Drafting the standard. They make the drafting of standard with the consultation of the committee. Analyzing the draft, they help the National Advisory Committee and Accounting Standard, they analyze the draft. Circulation of the data, after that they circulate to various government agencies, various departments of government, various corporate sector, various banks, financial institutions, they circulate that. So that they can get good feedback, good information, whether this accounting standard is applicable and it has implication or not, they have to analyze. Holding discussion and finalizing exposure draft. Here, the Institute of Chartered Accountant in India and the Chartered Accountant plays a very important role in holding discussion with the Accounting Standard Board and the National Advisory Committee on Accounting Standard, and they finalize that draft. After that, again, they circulate the exposure draft. Circulation of the draft and circulation of the exposure draft, the difference is that after the circulation of the first draft, they get the feedback. Then they hold discussion and they implement that. Circulation of the exposure draft, it will expose what they have taken into account and they wanted to be applicable. Then it will be finalized by basically by the committee and board and ICAI. Basically, ICAI members, chartered accountant, play a very important role because they are set up and statutory act under the parliament and finalized, and they can also modify and issue accounting standard. Issue accounting standard means the number of accounting standards, suppose accounting standard 1, accounting standard 2, till now 32, 33 are there, more are not issued. If they think they can issue new accounting standard. See, this is a list of accounting standard in India. This is all you have to remember. Accounting standard 1, accounting standard 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, like this, 9, 10, 11. You have to remember. Accounting standard 9 is revenue recognition. For example, suppose what revenue you are earning from interest, from dividend, that has to be recorded. Accounting standard 10, accounting for fixed asset. Suppose fixed asset, whether they're depreciated or not, that should be taken care of. Accounting standard 12, 13. 13, accounting for investment. Accounting for investment tells us that there are short-term investment and long-term investment. Short-term investment should be accounted and long-term investment should be accounted. Accounting for amalgamation. Suppose two company amalgamate, Hero and Honda. Both before was Hero was different and Honda was different. They amalgamated. Hero, Honda, they became. So, what is the accounts of Hero and what is the account of Honda, and when they amalgamated, what is the accounting? Accounting standard 4 tells us. Like this, 15, 6, 17, 18, 20, everything was there till it is 32. 30 was financial instrument we have to recognize and measure, then present, then we have to disclose. All this you have to remember the name and standard. This is of Indian accounting standard. IAS, you can also write, AS also write. AS means accounting standard. coming to IFRS. This has been implemented by, all throughout the world, and it work also is in progress, because maintaining a similar accounting standard, same accounting standard all throughout the world is very difficult. So International Financial Reporting Standard is a single set of accounting standard developed and maintained by the International Accounting Standard Board. As I was discussing, India has an accounting standard board. So in the international level, they have also an International Accounting Standard Board. What is the objective? Capable of being applied on globally consistent basis. Everywhere the same standard should be there. You go to Germany, you go to Australia, you go to America, you go to London, in the same accounting standard you can see and you can apply your techniques, accounting implication and auditing rules and regulations by developing emerging and developing economies. What does it provide? It provides investors and other users of financial statement with the ability to compare. It provides compare of financial information of publicly listed company on a like-to-like basis. Two publicly listed company of the same organization, of the same field, they have to compare. And with our international peers, one from Australia, one from America, one from India. So they can compare. Same accounting standard. IFRS now mandated for use by more than 100 countries. More than 100 countries have been using this, including the European Union and by more than two-thirds of the G20. G20 and other international organizations consistently supported the work of the International Accounting Standard Board and the mission of Global Accounting Standard. This is the IFRS. You have to remember the name. IFRS 1 is first time adoption of Indian accounting standard. So on the left hand side, we have, I have written IFRS. On the right hand side, that is in Indian, the name, Indian Accounting Standard 101. Change. See, from 8, the financial instrument issued. Here in Indian accounting standard, it is an exposure draft. We have studied the point exposure draft, that it's not been finalized, not been issued. The number is not given, that's why the number is not written. So you have to remember IFRS 1, what is IFRS 1, what is IFRS 2, what is IFRS 3, IFRS 4 insurance contract. Whatever insurance you do in any companies, there may be some rules and regulations. There may be double insurance you do re-insurance. Whatever insurance, there may be some rules and regulations. The rules and regulation is mentioned in the standard. So this, and there's a difference, maybe not visible, but I'm telling what the difference between IFRS and Indian GAAP or Indian accounting standard. You can tell Indian GAAP include various things, concept, convention, etc., etc. IFRS consists of financial statement, comprehensive income, cash flow, notes to account, and changes in account. It's a new definition of IFRS. But in Indian GAAP, we only use cash flow statement, balance sheet, PL, and notes to account. IFRS, no particular format is there, but in Indian GAAP, according to companies, Schedule 6 is there. So companies in 1956 and 2013 also has Schedule 6. Format of income statement, that is prescribed the format of income statement, but here the format statement is prescribed by Companies Act. Cash flow, it is mandatory. Here it is not mandatory. IFRS prohibit the presentation. Here it is allowed for presentation. Measurement of business income. Next, why we want to measure the income? When you do business, you earn income, you earn profit. Measurement of business income is the important function. In general term, any payment received in providing any services good is known as income. But here we are concerned with business income, means any surplus revenue over expenses is known as business income. Whatever revenue you have received, whatever expenses have incurred, there may be some surplus. Objective. What is the objective of measuring the business income? Because we want to make investment in future. If there is no income, there is no profit, how can you make investment in future? So if there is income, it will help us to invest. As a tax base also, if there is income, you have to pay tax. How much amount of tax you have to pay? What is the standard? What did the Act tells us as a guide to dividend policy? The more the profit and the more you have to pay to the employers in form of dividend, in form of bonus, because they are the real worker who work in the field day and night for your company. As an indicator of managerial efficiency, business income arises, if increases more, it tells us the management is working well and efficiency of the organization is effective. And you can overall measure the efficiency and creditworthiness. There are two approaches were there, one for transaction and another for balance sheet. What was transaction? Transaction tells us the more transaction you do daily, the more turnover you do daily, the more sale you do daily, the more income you arises. another balance sheet. That's better financial position. You can identify the balance sheet, more asset and liability. But in balance sheet, you tell you on both the side, asset and liability should be equal. Realization concept tells us, known as revenue recognition principle, which tells us that application of accrual concept towards the recognition of revenue. Which sales should be income realized when sales is made. And when sale is made, then we can tell that is there may be some profit. Under this principle, revenue recognized by the seller when it is earned. Irrespective of whether cash from the transaction is received or not. When you are selling any goods, either you are getting cash, you are telling that you earn profit. When you are not getting any cash, you are selling on credit, and you are telling it is you have earned but not received. Coming to unit 2. That was all about theory. And depreciation, we have 9 method. We'll discuss 2 method as per the syllabus. It is very important concept. Depreciation, we have already discussed in previous classes. Again, in the unit, it is there in the study material. Depreciation is a notion. First of all, depreciation is shown in the debit side of P&L account. Depreciation is shown as an expenses. Depreciation is helpful for income tax purpose. And depreciation is only charged on the fixed asset. What is depreciation? It is a permanent and continuous decrease or diminution in the quality, quantity, and value of an asset. It will define depreciation. When you're defining any depreciation, you take a definition of an author. So the quality of the product decreases, the quantity of the product decreases, and the value of the product also decreases. The other aspects regarding the other 4 aspects which are concept which are used in depreciation. One is depletion. What is depletion? It is used in basically mines. Big mines were taken on lease or quarries where you are digging the coal. Extracts from natural resources, from which it is known as wasting asset. Depletion is applicable to wasting asset because more you do the coal decreases. After 10 years, after 20 years, after 50 years, again, there will be. The mines would be empty. That is known as depletion. What is amortization? Refer to writing of the proportionate value of the tangible asset. We know that there are 2 types of asset, tangible and intangible. Intangible are the which cannot be touched and seen through hands and eyes of a person. Copyright, patent, goodwill, license, etc., etc. Franchise, etc. So this copyright and patent and goodwill, it should be write up of the professional value of the total asset. Suppose the value of the asset is 1 lakh and it should be written over a period of 10 years. So 1 lakh divided by 10. So 10,000 every year, 10,000 will be deducted. and after 10 years, the value of the asset will be 0. The amortization is applicable to intangible asset. Obsolescence refers to decrease in usefulness arising on account of external factor. Any external factor which makes its the asset obsolete, outdated, maybe due to changing technology, new invention, change of style, etc. That asset is known as obsolete and that to be replaced with a new asset. Fluctuation, any decrease or increase in market value of asset makes the product or asset to be less sellable or more sellable. So any asset means, and that fixed asset to depreciation to be charged. In case of other asset, this type of other concept of depreciation is adopted. What causes depreciation? Wear and tear. You are wearing that, you are using that, so depreciation will be there. So purchasing a product today and selling tomorrow also, there will be depreciation because time is consumed. Depletion already we have discussed, obsolescence also we have discussed. That also causes depreciation. What is the objective of providing depreciation? The objective of providing depreciation is to find out the true profit. Already I have told depreciation is a notional profit. When putting it on the debit side of PL, showing it in expenses so that the tax will be, by putting the showing in expenses, tax will be less. So we want to know the true profit. And also to want to know the true cost of production. What is the cost of production, total cost of production? Because of one, no. Because the machinery is running every day and that means from depreciation every day, wear and tear. So what is the total cost of production taking into account the depreciation? We have to find out. Because you have to present the financial, true financial position. We always tell, my dear learners, the financial position or the financial statement always exhibit or shows true and fair view of financial statement. It never tells us true and correct, because in spite of that, when the accounts been prepared, the audit also has been done, there may be some mistake, because human error, it is an inherent that human make mistake. But that's always written true and fair view of financial position. And we want depreciation is required because fund for replacement of asset, Walnag asset is there. Every year for 10 years, every year you have to show 10,000. So after 10 years, there we need fund. So that's why depreciation is shown as an expenses in the debit side of the account, because that 10,000 is kept as a fund for replacement of asset. What factors are needed for depreciation? What is the cost of the asset? What is the life of the asset? Scrap value if the asset is sold after 10 years or after the working life of the asset. And already I have told there are 8-9 methods. For depreciation, one is fixed installment method, diminishing balance method, annuity method, depreciation fund method, insurance policy method, revaluation method, depletion method, machine overhead method. But the first one and two is there in the study method, others are not. The first, straight line of fixed installment method. Here, a fixed rate of depreciation is charged on the original cost of the asset. And depreciation is calculated original cost of asset minus scrap value divided by estimated life of asset. D here stands for depreciation rate. C here stands for original cost of asset. S is known as salvage or scrap value, and N is estimated life of the asset. We'll do a simple problem. Illustration 1. From the following information, calculate the amount of depreciation. Here the cost of machine is rupees 30,000. Erection charges means the cost of installing a machine, that is 3,000, that will be added to the cost of the machine. Suppose you are purchasing a machine from one place to another, there may be some expenses. A person will come and install, that will take some charges also, that will be added to the cost of asset. Estimated useful life is 10 years and scrap value is 3,000. The formula will apply. The formula, depreciation is equal to cost minus scrap value divided by estimated life of asset. The cost is 30,000 plus 3,000, 33,000 minus scrap value is 3,000 divided by number of years is 10. So 33,000 minus 3,000 is 30,000. 30,000 divided by 10 is 3,000. The amount of depreciation will be 3,000 for every year. It will continue for 10 years. For 10 years, after 10 years, 30,000 will be there. So the asset value will be zero. This is the advantages and disadvantages of checking. Because straight line is very simple to understand. Because why simple? Because every year we know depreciation is fixed. Second point tells us amount of depreciation does not vary from year to year, because amount of depreciation is fixed. Suppose 3,000 every year, 3,000 for 10 years it is 3,000. Once you calculate, you can put that every year. Under this method, the book value of asset is reduced either to zero or scrap value, which case may be. Under this method, the book value of the asset means after deduction of depreciation from the original cost of asset, the value is there, that is known as book value, and the book value would be always zero in case of straight line method, which is not there in case of WDB or diminishing balance method. And depreciation charge is spent equally. Every year the depreciation charges are equally about the total entity of the working life. But in the number of working hours or life of the machine, till that number of working hours, the depreciation will be equal. It does not reflect the correct charge on account of depreciation. See, we are putting the depreciation equal, but does not tells us about the correct charge on account. Sometimes the wear and tear may be more or less, but we're putting that in equal. So this method has this limitation. It does not recognize that reality that the asset becomes older, the amount spent for repairs and goes increase. It doesn't also take into account, because after 5 years, you are putting the same depreciation of 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, 3,000, and the repair and renewal is increasing. The more you go increasing number of years, the repair and renewal will increase. It does not take into account the loss of interest on money invested in the asset. Whatever about the money you have invested, the interest also does not take into account. We have already studied in accounts interest on capital, interest on drawing. Other certain method like annuity while calculating depreciation takes interest into account, which is not in your course. Reducing balance method. This balance method name also known as diminishing balance method. It does not calculate fixed rate of percentage, because the first year the rate of depreciation is more, and second year the rate of depreciation is less, and third year the rate of depreciation is again less for the second year. and the depreciation is higher in the earlier years of asset. And this method gives a fair charge against income every year, because you know the depreciation, the more use of the asset and more depreciation, the depreciation amount increases, repair income increases. See the example, the plant has a $50,000 and subject to depreciation of 10%. The charge of depreciation year each year is follows 50,000, 10%, 5,000. In second year, you see that 5,000 will be deducted from 50,000. So it is 45,000. On 45,000, you put 10%. It will be 450. So the first depreciation is more and the second depreciation is less. So as you go on, the depreciation will be less and less. Third year, you see 45,000 minus 4,500. Upon that, you put 10%. That is 405. Like that, you go on deducting. Advantages, simple and easy to understand. And it is a real method because it gives the fair charge to profit loss account regarding depreciation repair. It tells us the accurate or more appropriate method of deducting the depreciation. And this method is adopted by Income Tax Department 1961, the diminishing balance method. Because here the income tax expenses of depreciation as an expenses is less, so the tax will be more. Disadvantage is that the value of asset cannot be here. The cost of asset after the certain period will not be equal to zero; it will be negative. After asset is put out of use, it may be have certain book value. Yes, there may be some book value, but it may be negative. This method does not take into account the loss of interest. This also does not take into account loss of interest. Like straight line method, only the annuity method takes into account the loss of interest. The determination of suitable date of depreciation is also difficult. Here, very difficult. If you cannot fix a suitable date of interest, you can fix in straight line 10%, and every year you can take 10%. Here, it is very difficult because you have seen in the example 5,000, 4,500, 4,050. Then very difficult. As a difference, I've taken as matter from a CA material. Straight line and reducing balance. Straight line is equal depreciation every year. The reducing balance is reducing depreciation every year. It's a very important question for the learners, apart from for the exam point of view. Total depreciation repairs may increase as the asset get older. Here, total depreciation may not vary from year to year. Here, where the value asset will be zero, the value asset cannot be zero. This is a formula, and this is the formula under reducing balance, which I will discuss. Here, depreciation by cost it is written. You can write original cost plus installation minus scrap value divided by number of years. A depreciation rate is equal to 1 minus square root of residual value by cost of asset in 100 to the power n. Straight line is suitable for asset which have low repair maintenance cost, lease, copyright, etc. Straight line method is used in case of reducing balance suitable of plant which have high repair and cost machine get older. Now, the important concept, tolerance. See, after preparation from journal and ledger, because you know the process of maintaining records in journal, you know the journalizing, making transaction transfer from journal to ledger, you know this posting, and trial balance records that amount of the accounts which are debited or credited from the ledger. The ledger account balances are reflected in trial balance at the amount which are debited and credited. After the transaction recorded in books of prime entry, journal, and posted to ledger, the next step is accounting process. Prepare the statement. Trial balance is not an account. It is a statement to check the arithmetical accuracy of the work. It will total calculate the amount of the debit side and amount of the credit side. It will tally. Because dual aspect concept applies here, the total of the debit, it will be total of the credit. The total of debit and total of credit will be equal to that. If not equal, then you have to verify whether there may be some mistake in trial balance, or if the mistake is more, you have to go to journal again and ledger. If you cannot find mistake, then we will put a different account or a suspend account. We'll discuss in the next slide. So trial balance is prepared on a particular date. On a particular date, it is prepared. And it is normally prepared on which date? At the end of the accounting period. It can be prepared at any time, but it is prepared normally at the particular date and at the end. But you can prepare at any time during the accounting period to check the accuracy. So that journal ledger is correct or not. This is the four very important objective of preparing trial balance. You check the arithmetical accuracy, addition, subtraction, all the correction, totaling is correct or wrong, and basis of financial statement. On the basis of these trial balance, the different accounts having different amounts, that is transferred to the trading and profit loss account balanced. If trial balance is wrong, then the balance sheet will be tally, may tally, may not tally, but it will be wrong. There may be some instances that trial balance and balance may tally, but there may be some error. Summary of ledger account. The trial balance source is the summary of ledger account. Total summary of the ledger account is posted in trial balance on the debit and credit side. Ledger account shows the debit and credit side for to be posted in trial balance. Location of error. Error in accounting can be detected before preparation of financial account, and steps are taken to locate and verify. Before preparing the financial statement, and there may be some error. Before error, during preparation and the financial error, and after also there may be some error. You have to locate and rectify the same. There are three methods of preparing trial balance. One is balance method, another is total. Balance method means you have to balance. Suppose on the one side it is given purchase, and it is put in the debit side here 50,000, and on the credit side it is written 5,000. So it indicates on the credit side it is known as purchase return. So you have to balance, minimize 50 minus 5, put on the higher side 45,000. This is balance method. Total method, you have to total, make total of the debit of the debit column, you have to make total of the credit column. And this combined balance and total method is not used nowadays. These two important methods are there. You can follow any one of the method. Basically, the total method is adopted. I'll give also an example of total method. This is the limitation of trial balance. It might be complete omission. Suppose you have not posted an entry in journal, so that entry may not be posted in trial ledger, and then not be an entry in trial balance. So you cannot find out. This is the limitation. Incorrect amount of both debit and credit. Debit you have written incorrect, and credit also have written incorrect. But that also is very difficult to find out in trial balance, because there are some error. We'll study in rectification of error, some error which is very difficult to detect, which affect, does not affect trial balance, and which affect trial balance. This comes under which does not affect trial balance. Entry of correct amount in wrong amount. Sorry, entry of correct amount in wrong account. It may be some mistake. So you have written, you entry to correct account. A correct account you put, but in the wrong amount. So there may be some problem we cannot find. Partial posting or double posting in ledger account. Twice you have posted on one side. Error of principal. Either in the PL side, you have posted that item in balance sheet, and the balance sheet asset you posted in the PL side. So they may be also disconnected and unable to find out, unless and until you see again and again. This is a format of trial balance given in solution. We have to understand and look. See, the serial number, you can you have to write, or you may not need that, but you have to write the name of the account or particulars. Here, debit balance rupees and credit balance rupees. Rupees is a must for the learners to write. A trial balance of the organization name you write as on 30 June, whatever the date given in the question and year. Name is cash account, so cash account always a debit balance. This is a format of your total method of trial balance. The total will calculate and put. Capital account, you know the credit balance given. Bank account, already it is given debit side. Purchase account also it is given on the debit side. Furniture given 5,000. I was talking of the purchase account. Suppose it is given is 22,000. And purchase account slash, here it will be given return. And in the credit side, against 22,000 will be given 2,000. So you have to deduct that 2,000 and you have to put on the debit side 20,000. That will be known as balance method. Furniture is a debit balance 5,000, sales credit balance. Return outward is known as purchase return. See, purchase return given there 1,000. Discount account 20, drawing 1,000, telephone 400, stationery 200, rent account 1,000, salary account 2500, return inward 200. This is all the items are taken from ledger account. So ledger account items are posted here. Unit 4. It also about rectification of error. There are some error which are to be rectified. As you know, we are human beings, so you are involved in accounting process. Mistake may be committed intentionally or unintentionally. Intentionally, which are committed, the error that is known as error, that is known as fraud. And unintentionally, which are committed, that is known as error. The mistake, what are the unintentional mistake? Maybe in mathematical figures, 38 you might have written as 83 or oversight or some simple mistake in application of accounting principle. And that be committed by account keeper or bookkeeper unintentionally. We have to rectify that. The error are divided into four types. One is error of commission, error of omission, compensating error, and error of principle. What is error of omission? They are of two types. Omission means we have omitted. We have not recorded in journal, we have not recorded in ledger, we have not recorded in trial balance. So it is error of complete omission. Total, you have forgotten the journal entry. Example, I have written, sale of goods to Rajiv on credit, not recorded in sales debut. So agreement of trial balance not affected with error. So trial balance will agree because total it is not there in journal, it is not composted to ledger, or from ledger it not come to trial balance. Partial omission. Example, for example, come to the example. Partial omission means one account is, suppose debit I have recorded, credit I have not recorded, or vice versa. Credit purchase of goods from Avinash and Co. recorded in a purchase day book and accordingly posted to purchase account. But Avinash and types of error affect the error. This type of error affect. Suppose we purchased from Avinash and Co. but recorded in purchase day book and posted to purchase account, but not posted to Avinash. So put a, we have debited the purchase, but have not credited Avinash. So it will affect the agreement of trial balance because one side will not agree. Error of commission. There may be some mistake by, done by the accountant. Maybe casting error, casting, maybe totaling may wrong ho jayega, posting may kuch galat ho gaya hoga, galat book may dal diya hoga. So error of commission, maybe error of recording also, recording in the wrong books. Example is sale of goods to Mr. Swain. Wrongly recorded in purchase. When we are making a sale, we are recording in purchase book. That is error of commission. And the posting, when a transaction is correctly recorded in the books of primary entry, but mistake is committed time of posting. Journal mein theek hum entry kiye hain, lekin posting jab ledger se hum kiye to galat kar diye. Purchase of goods on credit from RC Das, correctly entered in purchase the book, but accordingly debited to purchase account, but wrongly debited to RC Das. परचेज को डेबिट किया है आरसी दास को क्रेडिट करना चाहिए आरसी दास को भी हम डेबिट करते हैं तो इट इट मे अफेक्ट और मे नॉट अफेक्ट उसको हम देखना पड़ेगा बिकॉज दिस टाइप ऑफ एरर इज नॉट नॉर्मली ट्रायल बैलेंस नॉट अफेक्टेड बाय सच टाइप ऑफ एरर कास्टिंग व्हेन मिस्टेक इज कमिटेड बाय बुक कीपर इन कास्टिंग इन टोटलिंग टोटलिंग में अगर गलती हो गया है तो परचेज रिटर्न बुक इज टोटल तो उसमें कुछ गलती हो गया उसको बोलते हैं एरर ऑफ कास्टिंग एरर्स इन कैरी फॉरवर्ड इधर से उधर अगर ले जाएंगे ट्रायल बैलेंस से हम लेजर से ट्रायल बैलेंस लेने का टाइम अगर गलती कुछ करती है जनरल से लेजर पहले के कुछ गलती हो गया वेल कैरिंग फॉरवर्ड अ टोटल ऑफ वन पेज टू द नेक्स्ट पेज मिस्टेक इज कमिटेड एक पेज खत्म हो गया हम एंट्री कर रहे हैं जनरल और लेजर दूसरे पेज को अगर कैरी फॉरवर्ड कर रहे हो ये अमाउंट तो गलती हो गया कुछ द एग्रीमेंट ऑफ द ट्रायल बैलेंस इज अफेक्टेड बाय सच टाइप ऑफ एरर द टोटल ऑफ परचेज डे बुक कैरी फॉरवर्ड टू द सब्सिक्वेंट पेज 12000 तो उसमें गलती हो गया तो दिस नोन एज एरर ऑफ कैरी फॉरवर्ड दैट आल्सो इज नॉट अफेक्टेड कंपेंसेटिंग एरर This error are group of error and effect of one error is compensated by effect of another error. हमें एक गलती की है उस वो गलती को minimize करने के लिए दूसरा गलती हो गया unintentional. The net effect of such error do not affect agreement. तो debit का जगह we put a debit side the wrong amount and again we are putting the credit side wrong amount. तो minimize हो गया balance हो गया will not affect. Error of principle, you know, error of principle means when a capital item is treated as a revenue item or vice versa. Revenue item is treated as capital item. This is called the error of principle. Then there is a violation of accounting principle, then type of error. Error of principle means the violation of accounting principle. Incorrect allocation of expenditure or receipt between capital and revenue item result in such type of error. When you are unable to distinguish between capital and revenue item, then error of principle arises. The revenue items are to be shown in a PL account, but not shown in balance sheet. Then error of principle arises. When a fixed asset to be shown in balance sheet, but is shown in PL account or trading account, then we know we called it error of principle. The agreement of trial balance is not affected by occurrence of such error. अगर कुछ error ही हुआ है, तो agreement trial balance कुछ affect नहीं होगा. For example, wages paid to Masun for making a platform for installation machine is wrongly debited to wages account instead of machinery account. तो wages payment किए हम उसको wrongly debit किए wages को उसको किसने wages payment किए machinery के लिए तो machinery वो add हो जाएगा it should be added because purchase of asset is passed to purchase book but wrongly debited to wages account. Machinery add करना था हम wages में डाल दिए machinery होगा तो asset में जाएगा wages आ गया तो trading में आ गया. errors affecting the agreement of the trial balance. This discussed the rectification error. We need to be clear with errors affecting the agreement of trial balance. So following error affect the agreement. Kya? Wrong totaling, casting, subsidiary book. Subsidiary book, you know, purchase book, purchase return, sales book, sales return, bills receivable, bills payable, general purpose. Incorrect balancing of ledger account. Balancing में अगर गलत हो गया ledger account में तो affect करेगा. Posting wrong side of ledger account. Posting on the wrong side, debit side instead of credit side. The account, omission of posting from subsidiary to respective ledger. Omission मतलब posting नहीं किया. Forgotten to post. Balance of ledger account. Writing the ledger account balance in wrong column total. अगर wrong column में हम लिख दिए ledger account का balance. Debit side में trial balance लिखना चाहिए था, credit side में लिख दिए. Casting missing in trial balance. This error are not affecting. Already हम पढ़ चुके हैं complete omission of entry in books of total journal में posting नहीं है, ledger posting नहीं है तो trial balance पे आएगा नहीं. Posting on wrong side of wrong account, उस थोड़ा गलत था, इस पर ठीक हुआ है. Posting on wrong side of wrong correct side of wrong account. Correct side में है debit credit तो ठीक है, लेकिन गलत अकाउंट को चला गया, राम के जाग में शाम को चला गया. Recording the transaction in books of original entry with wrong amount. जर्नल में हम एंट्री किए हैं, गलत अमाउंट में एंट्री किए हैं. Recording transaction book entry twice. We have put entry in journal twice. Error of principal and compensating error. This will not affect the agreement of trial balance. I'm talking about suspended account. When the trial balance does not agree, either the debit or credit side, apart from where we have to disclose, we have to look at the error and we have to rectify. We have to search from trial balance, we have to search from ledger, journal, etc. Everything. Apart from that, also we are not unable to find out the error. So the difference in the total of if the debit is more and credit is less, on the credit side we'll put the account on the suspended and we'll search. We'll tell you the trial balance and we'll search. After a reasonable check to look at error, if few errors still remain making the trial balance disagree, the difference in trial balance is transferred to an account called suspended account, in which the trial balance is to be tallied. Till the errors are located and rectified. Unless we balance the trial balance, the financial statement cannot be prepared. So we'll balance the trial balance and we'll prepare the financial statement, or we'll check from journal to ledger what is the mistake. After checking if the mistake is caught, then the suspended account will be removed. The suspended account will have a debit or credit balance depending upon the column of trial balance. Already I have told. If debit is more, we'll put on the credit side. Credit is more, we'll put on the debit side. This error will affect the trial balance because we are unable to get the error. After rectification, the suspended account still shows a balance, then it is transferred to the asset side or liability side of the balance. After rectification, also in suspended account, that you have to transfer to the asset side or liability side. If suspended account will be debit balance taken to asset, and suspended account will be credit balance taken to liability side or capital side of the balance sheet, whatever you can tell. Then you known as rectification of error. When errors are located, steps are taken to rectify. And rectification in accounts, the golden rule is that principle is that you cannot override, you cannot cut in accounts. For that, you have to pass an entry. Suppose you have to, the journal entry would have been wages to cash, but you have put wages to RAM. So you cannot cut RAM and to write to cash. In exam also, you pass an rectifying entry. Error is not done by overwriting, but by passing upper bound entry. The procedure of rectification depends on the stage of location. Where is the area? Error stage of location of errors. The stage may be before preparation of trial balance. Before preparation of trial balance, may mean journal and ledger, so no suspended account was created. Or after preparation of trial balance, but suspended account already be created. The trial balance prepared, you prepare final, the trading profit and balance sheet. Or the, when after preparing final account also, there may be some error. So the before all the I have written, example is see, the error may affect only one account or two. When it affects only one account, it means one-sided error. There are two type of error, one-sided and two-sided. When error affecting one side, it is known as one-sided account, or it affecting two accounts, it may be two-sided. One-sided error rectify passing a suitable explanation. You see, in case of only one-sided error, you find a suspended account more often. Suppose if the purchase account is overcast, sales account is undercast, in that case, you will find only suspended account. Either on the debit or credit side of the consolidated ledger account. Such error are not rectified by passing journal entry, overcasting of purchase day book. Since the error lies on the one account, purchase account, any one-sided error, so it will be overcast of purchase account. For the purchase account is more, you have to reduce that. For reducing purchase account debit, the purchase account always debit balance, you have to credit that, so there will be suspense account debited to purchase. This is a journal entry we will rectify. This is very important work of the accountant and the auditor checks it. If there is any mistake in the accounting entry, how to rectify? You have to first read the question very thoroughly. Give journal entries to rectify the following errors. Purchase of machinery of 5,000 wrongly passed the purchase book. See, in the first, a machinery is there. Purchase of machinery means here, when machinery is there, purchase remains silent. Asset is purchased, but you have put in purchase account. Purchase book. Purchase book means when you are purchasing any credit goods, credit purchase of goods. So asset is purchased, but you have posted in purchase account. See what the journal entry will be. Machinery account able to purchase. You have to purchase asset and you put in purchase account. Because the correct entry is machinery to cash, but you put in purchase account to cash. So purchase account is debit, we have to credit it. So machinery account debited to purchase account. And cash is already correct. Up to the next question. Repair to machinery wrongly debited to machinery account. See, repair is done. Repair account on the first left side, the repair is to be done, but it put on the wrong account. Machinery has been debited. The repair would have been debited, machinery wrongly debited. The wrongly debited should be rectified. The wrongly debited should be credited. The repair has been debited, should have been debited correctly. So debit repair and credit machinery. Debit repair and credit machinery. Amount is correct. Come to next. Rent of 1,000 paid to landlord, debited to landlord account. Rent has been paid, but debited to landlord account. See. Rent has been paid, but it was debited to landlord. But it should have been rent account, rent to cash. But by mistake, it is made landlord to cash. The landlord should be has been debited by mistake. It should be credited. The landlord rent account debited to landlord. Come to the fourth. Check of 3500 received by SK Naik, credited in the account of SK Das. The check has been received by SK Naik. The journal entry is bank account debited to SK Naik. But wrongly, it has been credited to bank account debited to SK Das. So in spite of SK Naik, it has been SK Das. SK Das has been credited wrongly. So if credited wrongly, you have to minimize when any credit entry is credited, you have to do rectification, you have to debit it. And the debit entry has been to be rectified, you have to make it credit. The SK Das should be debited and SK Naik should be credited. Same is the case. Sale of goods to Hari on credit for 450. Here is an important concept. The amount is wrong. 450 and 540. The sold goods to Hari on credit. So it will be Hari to sell. 450, 450. But wrongly recorded in the sales table book as 540. See the entry. The difference is 90 rupees. Because we have sold more. We have sold for 450. But wrongly we have sold for more. The wrong more should be reduced. What is the amount to be reduced is 90 rupees. So we have sold goods to Hari. Hari is to sell. It should be opposite. Sell to Hari. Sorry. Last, sell of old furniture 500 wrongly passed to the sales book. Same case. Furniture is there and here sales book. See. Sales account debited to furniture because we have to, first you have to told furniture. Cash to suppose furniture, then cash to sell. The sell was credited, sell should be debited. Lot of practice should be there. Coming to the last unit of bank reconciliation statement. So, this bank reconciliation statement, before introducing this, I want to tell that when a depositing or opening account in bank, we have one passbook and bank have also a book. Bank with the book which is kept by the bank. The name of us is known as cash book. A bank keep cash book and we keep passbook. A modern business perform transactions through bank. We know, everybody know, the bank is a very important criteria into this world. Generally, bank receive cash for bank deposit and make cash payment by issuing check. In order to keep record of the transaction, you maintain a cash book with bank column. It is in fact a bank account in the name of the business. Our account bank keeps in his business. And cash. On the other hand, bank also maintain customer account in the book. Whenever the business opens an account in the bank, by depositing the same amount, the bank provides the checkbook, helping withdrawal and payment of cash. And the passbook which show the detailed statement of customer account in the bank. Whatever the amount or the amount of rupees we have deposited to the bank keeps in his cash book, and the same is reflected in our passbook. It should tally. If it does not tally, then there is some problem. That is, we have to make tally, reconcile. The amount which is shown in the passbook, then same amount should be shown in the cashbook of the bank in your name. But if there is any difference, suppose in your passbook it is showing 50,000, you have deposited an amount, but bank is showing 30,000. So there is a difference of 20,000. You have deposited a check of 20,000, but it has not been shown, it's showing in the bank cashbook, but it's showing in your passbook. There may be some situation. We have to tally that. We have to make the bank understand that it is showing 50,000 in the passbook, but bank is showing it is 30,000. So the bank reconciliation statement is not a mandatory statement to be prepared. Normally, it is prepared by the customer because the customer can identify when he find the from bank is showing a different amount and he has a different amount in his passbook. What is the bank's reconciliation statement, BRS? It is a statement which is prepared to reconcile balance shown by passbook, maintained by bank, and the cashbook column. Everything is maintained by bank, but the passbook is given to the customer. And the cashbook is maintained by the trader. And finding the causes of difference between the two balance. What is the difference between the two balance? Bank reconciliation is the balancing of a company cash account balance to a bank account balance. So balance of the company cash in the bank and balance of the bank account in the passbook of the customer. It is, I've told, it is prepared by the customer or trader. And it contained a complete and satisfactory explanation of the difference balances per cashbook and passbook. Passbook is known as bank statement. Also, you can find out. And it is prepared on the closing date of account, maybe December 31st, March 31st. Sometimes it is prepared at the end of every month after preparing cashbook or after any interval to check whether accuracy of cash is maintained properly or not. It's neither not a journal nor a ledger. It is a statement with a vertical presentation of facts, having starting from cashbook to passbook and the differences with the addition and subtraction. It starts with the given balance of any book and ends with the balance of another book. See, there are four methods in bank reconciliation statement. I'll show the format. It starts with balances for cashbook and it will end with balances for passbook or vice versa. You start with the balances for passbook and end with the balances for cashbook. Suppose balances for cashbook, if there are overdraft balances for cashbook, then it will end with overdraft balances for passbook. Overdraft balances for passbook, it will start and it will end with overdraft balances for cashbook. Four types are there. First, balances for cashbook, it will start and it will end balances for passbook. Then opposite. And reverse, balances per passbook it will start and end balances per cashbook. Then the balance which is positive balances per cashbook, it will be negative balance. Suppose negative balances or overdraft balances per cashbook, it will start and with overdraft balances per passbook. Reverse, overdraft balances per passbook it will start, it will end with overdraft balances per cashbook. If you remember one format, you can do every other three format. The first two are important. For arithmetical calculation, all the regions are grouped in odd categories and this shows a disagreement. There may be some disagreement. Suppose check you have deposited but not credited. So there may be some disagreement. And it is not legally compulsory to prepare a bank reconciliation statement. Also, I have already told, not legally compulsory, the customer prepared to verify. And the advantages of a bank reconciliation statement, it makes account to be in good standing, good position, whole transaction and accurate balance. Because of this bank reconciliation statement, there was some scandal. The same problem they had occurred, the bank reconciliation statement, the balance was shown by the bank and the balance they had, there was a lot of difference. It will keep mistake at by, there will be less amount of mistake. It will detect accounting error and will have accurate balance. This is a disadvantage. You can create checks that clear the bank after being voided. A check you have deposited, you have to check. It issue unclear check that continue not to be presented. The unclear check which needed to be cleared, it is also clear. So there may be also some fluctuation. A risk changes in the date covered by the bank statement. There may be some dates after closing date, there may be some check deposited. That also is a problem. It makes possible the deposit check could be returned. The check which are deposited also if you are dishonored will be returned. That's also an important disadvantage. It is having many missing transactions. Some missing transaction also will be. So, check is missed or transaction is missed, entry is missed, then there will be problem. Need and importance of bank reconciliation statement or BRS. Then show the accuracy of the balance shown by passbook and cashbook. Both passbook and cashbook it will show the same balance. It provides a check on the accuracy of entry made in the books. It helps to detect and rectify error committed in both cashbook and passbook. It helps to update the cashbook by discovering some entries. And it indicates an undue delay. There will be any delay in clearance or collection of check or deposit of check, entry in check, credit of the check, issuing the check. That also it will indicate. Moreover, it has a diverse role to play for the betterment of the organization, pinpoint the mistake in the cashbook passbook, identify delay in clearance of check, why there is any delay in clearance of check, is there any holiday, public holiday, checking on embellishment, any misappropriation or embellishment of cash, checking accuracy of cashbook, and technique of control. The region, there are a lot of regions, but I have categorized this type of region. Other regions are near about this region for this. Why the cashbook and passbook does not tally, do not show the same amount, which the certain scandal took place. There may be check may be issued, a check may be drawn, but not paid. You issue the check, but not paid to them. You have kept by yourself. So there may be some difference. Check deposited for collection, but not collected. Not credited with the bank amount, deposited direct to the bank. Income collected by bank, any income has been collected by bank, but not recorded in the passbook. Bank has recorded in the cashbook, but you have not updated your passbook, so it has not entered into your passbook. Interest on deposit. Error and omission, expenses paid by bank directly. Any expenses or bank charges, bank has deducted, but not reflected in your passbook. After you have to update, then you will show it has been deducted. This is the detail objective. There are no unrecorded checks. Checks that clear record the deposit clear the bank or transact or in the check in transit. Suppose you have State Bank, you have to deposit a deposit a check of Bank of Baroda, and it will take time. And clearance will be in correct amount. A check deposit recorded intact the following day. And if there is a public holiday, then the next day it should be check will be deposited. Check clear the bank are valid in amount. Other adjustment in the bank are valid and need to be adjusted. Any error? Ascertain number two, ascertain the following. Record deposit clear the bank, whether the deposit has been clearance has been received from the bank or not. Cash deposit are recorded, the same thing. The verify outstanding, etc. etc. Coming to the format, this is a very important format. Suppose balance is for cash book, we have to add. Unprojected check or other credit directly to the bank, and you have to less deposit in transit, this sum of check, other item. You'll find balances for bank books. Another format is there. This format also, the format are there, you can remember, or you have to identify who should be added and who should be deducted, so that the balance passbook is given and the balance of cash book will come out. Balance passbook 4000 and balance of cash book 1400. Why there is some difference? Because some addition and some subtraction should be made. Addition is, suppose the insurance premium has been paid by bank, and so it should be added to the passbook. It is not added. It will be added to passbook. In the check recorded twice in passbook, it is not recorded. It will up to date in the passbook. Check deposit not yet collected. When you collect, it will be recorded in the passbook. Bank charges debited, it will be added in the passbook. Already bank has debited in cashbook, less check issued but not presented, check recorded twice in cashbook, dividend received recorded only in bank system. You can also identify which are to be added and which are to be deducted. This is another format. So your balances for cashbook, you will get balances for passbook, and this item, the four item to be added and this item to be deducted. If you do balances for passbook, the up and balances for cashbook, and those items were added to be subtracted, those items which are subtracted to be added. See, the balances for cashbook is there. Add check issued but not presented for payment. Check has been issued but not presented for payment. It will take time for presentation for payment. Interest credited to the bank but not recorded in cashbook. And debtor directly paid into bank but not recorded in cashbook. Wrong credit by banker. Collection by banker is for customer standing interest. This all have to be added when there will be balances for cashbook. If there will be balances for passbook, it all will be subtracted. Another thing you would identify, balances for cashbook is similar to the overdraft balances for passbook. Then the less will be check deposited but not credited. This one of check appearing in the passbook but not enter. Bank charges as per passbook, wrong debit, and payment as per standing instruction. And this is a very important problem. I have taken a very difficult problem. Overdraft balance I have taken. In the following particulars, prepare a bank reconciliation statement to find out the cause of difference in two balance, August 31st, 2016. A company name is Four Star Private Limited. awarded balance of bank statement is 17,000. Check issued but not encashed, not presented for payment. Dividend also are collected banker. Interest charged by the bank recorded twice. Check deposited for bank statement not entered in cash book. Credit statement of bank column cash book short. Cash sought. Club dues paid by bank to standing institution not recorded in cash book. On creditor check due to outstation. See the solution. As to let the bank out as per bank statement is 17,000. Check issued I wallet toll. Check issued as per but not present of payment 2300. Dividend also collected is to be added 2300. Interest charge but recorded twice so to add it 500. Check deposit not entered cash book to add it 3400. And what are the item to be deducted? Credit side of bank account on cash book short. There is a short. We have to less it. And because it is in cash book, and we have to find out the cash book. Club dues paid by bank. Bank has paid club dues. So we have to deduct it. We already it was added. Uncredited check due to outstation. Some uncredited check has been due to outstation. Some check were not credited. So you have to deduct it. Total is 6100. So you'll find the balance is 19,300. The difference was of 2000 or something. This is all about. Any question? Any question, sir?
No, very absurd. There is no question. Learners are requested to note down the questions in the chat box if you have any. One thing somebody has asked, please start the. Chagatika, what is the first question? Please, sir, start the what? Start the session. Okay. So,
not a question, I mean, one depreciation.
Depreciation. You want to know what is depreciation? Probably he means that what is the meaning of depreciation?
What is depreciation? Oh, depreciation is the gradual decrease in wear and tear and passage of time and gradual decrease in value of an asset. And you know, depreciation is always charged on fixed asset. So whenever you are using any fixed asset, so depreciation will be charged.
Is it clear, sir? I want another issue. What is that?
How can I ask?
Please type it in the chat box. Okay, no issue, Mr. Mishra. You can write down the question there itself. Ten questions. You can unmute also yourself. Swagatika, can you guide him how to unmute?
Yes, sir. Click on your pick, then three options are there, and please unmute the audio options.
Mr. Mishra, you can unmute the microphone.
Audio options. There are three type of options. One is call options, then second one is video options, and third one is audio options. Then unmute the audio options. Click the audio options.
Please unmute the audio option. As our technical support staff has requested you to do that, please unmute the audio option.
Click on the middle part, means your pick. Click on the your pick.
Probably he is finding it difficult.
I can write in the chat box.
Yes, left, sir.
Okay. By Mr. Crowley, he has left. Again, he may be joining. Anyway, if there is no more question, we can sum up for today's online class on accounting standards and depreciation. Actually, sir has lucidly clarified things, beginning with accounting standard and coming down to bank reconciliation statement. Accounting standard, as he has explained, because due to the globalization also, there should be some sort of standardization in accounting process. Otherwise, trade and commerce will suffer. Then we come to your trial balance. Trial balance, as sir has explained, trial balance takes into account the non-zero balance of ledger accounts. What does it mean by non-zero balance? That means once a ledger is balanced, both sides tally, there is no balance left. We have neither carried down any balance nor we have brought down any balance. No balance is left. Both sides tally. Then no amount is coming under that particular head to the trial balance. That means trial balance is the summary of debit balances of ledger accounts as well as credit balances of ledger accounts. In the trial balance, first we mention the debit balances and credit balances of assets, then liabilities, then owner's equity. Once both sides tally, then we are a bit sure that there is no arithmetical inaccuracy. It testifies the arithmetical accuracy. But sir has also explained you what types of errors, even if both sides tally in a trial balance, it does not mean that there is no error in transfer, posting, recording, whatever it is. And sir has also explained what kinds of errors are disclosed by trial balance and what kinds of errors cannot be disclosed by trial balance. There is a simple mathematical formula, or you can say tip. If both sides do not tally, find out the difference, divide it by 2. Then try to locate that item on the side which is higher. Suppose the difference, after dividing it by 2, the difference is 100. Try to find out a figure of that amount in the higher side, higher column. If debit side, debit column is higher, find it in the debit column. If the credit side column is higher, find it out in the credit side column. Again, if you try this tip to some extent, another tip is that if you divide the difference by 9 and you get a whole number, the difference was 1800 divided by 9, 200, divisible, a whole number you get, and it is divisible. There is a possibility of transposition of figures. What is transposition of figure? 5300 might have been posted or mentioned as 3500. That is another tip. But if the small two tips failed, then of course there is no way out but go to check the error by analyzing step by step in your posting and your posting of the ledgers as well as in other accounts. Then depreciation, one point was there in the written down value method. If you go on passing the depreciation amount, a time comes either it may have negative balance also. There is a simple rule in that it cannot be negative balance. Or if the residual balance is small one, then it is left as it is or adjusted with the scrap value. Or when the asset is disposed of, then the total amount to receive, we compare it with the residual value already taken or the residual value in the depreciation account, and we take into account. Suppose the scrap is taken as 3000 rupees. we have already fixed the scrap value will be 3000 rupees. And our depreciation account shows another small balance of 100 rupees. But we sold the asset for 4000 rupees. Now our profit is 900 rupees because we have assumed only scrap value to be 3000 rupees. And the depreciation left out is 100 rupees. So we get a profit of 900 rupees. The reverse is maybe taken to profit and loss account, maybe loss, maybe profit. In banking, what happens? I'm telling one example. In the last year, even if you are calculating the depreciation on straight line method, 1000 is the cost of the machinery, 10 years, 10% at the rate of 10%. That means in the last year also, the depreciation will be 1000, so the residual value will be zero. No. 1 rupee is left out because the value of the asset cannot be zero. At least 1 rupee is kept as a token amount so that the asset will be reflected in the books of accounts till it is finally disposed of. Finally disposed of means either you can sell it or you can donate it, whatever it is. That will be taken out of the books of accounts. That is another way. Then sir has explained reconciliation statement. Either you can start with your casebook. Here casebook means bank column. You are matching the bank column with that of the passbook. If you are making a multi-columnar casebook, if it is a single columnar casebook, then the cash balance should be always taken care of, deducted from the total to find out the bank balance. Accordingly, the reconciliation statement has to be prepared. Once you start with your own balance, the simple tip is undo what you have done, do what the other party has done. That is, your balance, cash book balance is X, whatever you have done, but the bank has not done. Undo it. Undo it means if you have plus, minus it. If you have minus, plus it. Plus, minus. And the other side. What other side has done, but you have not done. Do it. Repeat it. Then automatically we'll find the balance of other thing. Overdraft. Overdraft is an exception. Unless and until you have taken a loan or a loan is not sanctioned to you or overdraft agreement is not there, it will not be a negative balance. Never. But overdraft is a negative balance. And in the overdraft, the situation gets reversed because it is minus. When we add something to the minus means we are actually deducting something. This plus minus simple formula will be applicable to you. Thank you, sir. You have lucidly explained such a lengthy topic, but in a very short time, in a perfect manner. The examples are beautiful examples you have quoted. We didn't feel that you have not used a blackboard. Your PPT explained well to the learners. And learners, you have probably no other questions to ask, sir. So with my thanks to all of you and with a sincere request to submit your assignments on time. And also, please, please go through the SLMs before the class as well as after the class to know it better. And if you have got any doubts, don't hesitate to ask in the subsequent classes also. Thank you very much for attending the classes. And Mr. Mishra, probably you have again joined, but you didn't ask any question. Anyway, if there is no more questions, sir, then we can call it a day. And I once again thank you, Dr. Jena.
Thank you, sir.
For his wonderful presentation and deliberation of the topic. Accounting standards and your trial balance. So I request the technical support staff, with my thanks to her, Swagatika madam, to
thank you, sir.
Close the session, requesting the learners to de-link from the link. Thank you very much. Thank you once again. I also request you to stay safe and stay secure. Please go through the SLMs. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.